All the classics, all the time, right here on Belfast 89 FM. That's got to be one of my favourite songs of all time. It's been recorded by so many people down the years, including the lady who's now in the studio beside me. Yeah, it's Rosemary's version of The Wind Beneath My Wings. And as if by magic, you're here.
Good morning, Robin.
Good morning, good morning. How?
What time in the morning do you call this?
I know. How did you end up in Belfast at this time on a Friday morning?
Oh, no, that would be telling.
Or you haven't gone home from the night before.
Exactly. Anything to get on your show, Robin.
That's it. Well, it's lovely to see you this morning.
And likewise, likewise.
If I had have known you were coming in, I would have had a shower. Anyway.
You're looking fine.
Thank you, thank you. Loving that version of Wind Beneath My Wings. I haven't heard that in years.
Yeah, that's on my Christmas album, and I've always loved that song. I mean, it's got beautiful words. And mind you, Bette Midler did a good job of her version too.
She did, exactly, yeah. So talking about Christmas, how festive does Belfast look at the moment?
It's looking amazing. And I can't wait to be here at Christmas doing the pantomime. So I meet all the fans while I'm going shopping and all that, you know.
I was wondering how many minutes it was going to take before you mentioned the panto. We're 90 seconds into the interview.
I know, because I'm excited to be in Belfast doing pantomime at the wonderful Crescent Arts Centre.
It's been a few years since you were in panto, wasn't it?
Yes. The last one I did was, I think it was with Clive Dunn. But the first one I ever done here, it was with Frank Carson, and that was at the Opera House. And, I've done about 12 or 14 pantos altogether, working with, apart from the lovely Frank, Les Dawson, Bernie Winters, Clive Dunn. So I've been lucky to work with some of the greats, you know.
And a lot of people will remember Clive Dunn, of course, not only for being Grandad on TV, but for being Corporal Jones in Dad's Army.
Absolutely. He was such an amazing person. And he used to come into my dressing room, and he was always eating lychees, you know, the Chinese fruit. And he used to buy them in the market and sort of, well, you like a wee lychee? And if it wasn't lychees, it was chocolates, you know. We were in and out of each other's dressing rooms all the time. That was the same with Les Dawson. They say the bigger the star they are, the nicer they are, you know. He was great fun. Very funny on stage as well, you know. So that was Robin Hood that I played. And of course, Jack and the Beanstalk, that was with the lovely Les Dawson.
And was Les as much fun in real life as he was on the telly?
Oh, God. More. I mean, I was on his BBC TV show, and it was prime time on a Saturday night. And I had a song out called These Boots Are Made for Walking. And I was wearing a wee short skirt, you know, like you do. And of course
I remember the cover for that. I remember the single.
Do you?
Yes. And there was lots of legs in the shot.
Yes. Well, there had to be, didn't there? And I was wearing like a little sort of top and a little jacket and everything. And he says, we've got a turn coming. I can't do the accent. Got a turn coming on now. And it's not a frock she's wearing. It's a pelmet. Now, nobody would know what a pelmet is, you know, these days, which is, you know, it's part of the curtains. We did a little sketch together as well. And I sang These Boots Are Made for Walking. And he said, the other announcement he said was, apart from how short my skirt was, he says, she's got a voice that would warn shipping in the Solent. Ladies and gentlemen, Rosemary. And I thought to myself, somebody says to me one time, I quoted that on a lot of my biogs. And a couple of people said to me, you must have been very upset about that. And it's in a lot of my biogs. And I sort of says, God, you can't get upset with Les, you know, because that was his humour.
And I was like to think the way Morecambe and Wise used to joke with Des O'Connor.
Absolutely.
And Des loved it in the end. He did.
Of course he did. Good publicity for him.
Talking about Des, I saw a clip recently on social media of you singing on the Des O'Connor show.
Yes, somebody sent that to me, Who's Sorry Now, and I shared it. And I've been lucky enough to be several times on the Des O'Connor show.
But it's kind of sad in a way that those days of great television have gone now, isn't it? The variety shows, the seaside specials, the full variety thing.
Yeah, I was on that there, and it was Roy Walker that hosted that. And that was at the BIC in Bournemouth. And it's a massive, massive place. Thousands and thousands of people. And but as you said, there's not enough. I think there's something on the London Palladium now with Mike McIntyre, and a lot of silly things with mobile phones and audience going into the audience and that. So it doesn't look as slick as it did the production of it from years ago.
Yeah. But it's not the same. Yeah. I mean, I remember watching it. You would have had people like Michael Barrymore on doing his stuff. You would have had yourself on, as you said, Roy Walker, Jimmy Cricket. The Nolans seemed to be on every show, didn't they, back then as well, you know? Yes. Anyway, let's play another one of your records. I've got The Answer to Everything, Danny Bai. It's a special song, isn't it?
Absolutely. Oh, yeah, one of my favourites. I love it. And it's a big favourite with my concert audiences.
So here we go. Here's Rosemary and The Answer to Everything. 89.3 FM. Fabulous version of The Answer to Everything here on Belfast 89 FM from Rosemary, who has kind of ended up in Belfast for some weird reason this morning, and we got her in here in the studio. The thing that amazes me about you is how alive you are at this time on a Friday morning.
Well, I'm an early riser. I get up and I go to the gym, and I like to keep my energy levels up, and I never sleep in. Never, ever. But you're any excuse to come down to Belfast, for goodness sake.
Because I remember coming to see you in Blackpool one time, and you were walking up and down from the North Pier to the South Pier every day. That's some mileage.
Well, and I think nothing of that. And it was great because I did live opposite the Irish Sea, and I always felt healthy because you're getting the sea air, you know. And I used to walk on the beach when the sea wasn't too rough. But you can still get close to the beach, you know. And I thought nothing of that, from pier to pier.
So do you miss Blackpool?
Well, I have a fondness for Blackpool. I always sort of, my career started there. And I had a wonderful agent at the time, Norman Teal. So, well, early part of this year, I did a season at the Viva. And so I did a couple of seasons there. And it's like a mini Las Vegas type of club. And it was great because it was 5 minutes from where I lived. So that was great. And I get to go to Blackpool quite a lot. So, but I certainly love living there.
And of course, you would have seen your old friend Joe Longthorne all the time in Blackpool, and you must miss him terribly.
Terribly. I lived around the corner from Joe, but I met him on the Des O'Connor show, and it was on the New Year's Eve show, and it was the first time I met him, and he'd just given up the impressions to do the singing, and he showed me the new album. I says, "That looks like the best of Rosemary. You've nicked all my songs." And he says, "Oh, I know, Rose. I know," because he's from Hull and he had that sort of accent. And he says, "I know, but I'm such a big fan." So what could I say? Do you know what I mean? I certainly wasn't mad at all, but we became friends ever since that time we both appeared on the Des O'Connor show. So, yeah, I miss him terribly. And it's strange. And I also miss Frank because Frank lived not that far from me. And so that was my second time moving into Blackpool. You know, when my career started, I moved from London up to Blackpool, and then when I came back from the States after living in LA and doing my concerts in Vegas and studying acting and all that there, I decided I'd go back to Blackpool, and I enjoyed it second time around as well. So now I'm back in my hometown, and so I always kept a house there, so I'm lucky enough that, you know, to have the house there, you know. So it's I have to keep moving for security reasons, social security.
So your schedule's getting really busy at the moment. You're about to go into rehearsals for Panto at the Crescent Arts Centre, Aladdin, and you're the genie.
I sure am, yes, and this will be a first for me now, playing this role. And it's nice to play a different role, because I played Dick Whittington loads of times, and Robin Hood, and Jack and the Beanstalk, so, and the Funny Fairy. So this is a first for me, and it's a great character. So I can't wait to do it.
And I suppose all the people want to know, is there going to be big songs for you in this show?
Yes, yes. I'm not sure how many just yet, because I'll find out at rehearsals, but yes, people know me for the big ballads, you know, and there'll be audience participation. You know, I like to get the audience all joining in and yes, clapping along and singing along, you know. It has to be fun for all the family.
And the great thing about the run of Aladdin, we're going right up until the 22nd of December, so it's going to be really, really festive-y and Christmassy, isn't it?
Yes, yes, it will be. I can't wait. And it'd be nice to sort of say, there's a lot of the fans wrote to me on social media from Belfast, and they sort of said they're looking forward to seeing me after I you know, perform and that there. So it'll be great to see some of the Belfast people again.
What's 2020 got in store? Do we know yet?
Well, I'm hoping to tour sort of all the Hastings Group hotels all around the north of Ireland. And so it'll be a tour. Not sure when it starts, but probably the early part of the year. And I'll record a new album as well.
That's what I was going to say. Is there a chance we'll get you back into the studio?
Oh, absolutely. Any excuse to come into Belfast and see you, Robin. Be on your show. Tell you my life story again.
That's what I was going to say. I'm going to plug that because we did a TV special together a few weeks back.
That's right. You had a great rapport from the public. Read that. We had a good laugh doing it, didn't we?
We did, actually. We did. So that was the big interview, and it's still available online. If people want to check it out, go to the website nvtv.co.uk, and they can watch that on there as well. I've got a load of music here from the 1960s and 1970s. So I'm going to ask you to choose the next track that we play on the show this morning. So any song in the world from the 60s or the 70s, what would you like to hear?
Anything by Joe Dolan.
Oh, wow. Because Joe was such a legend. And yes. We miss him terribly, don't we?
Yes. Oh, gosh, he was fantastic. And I did a song with him at the Opera House. And I was sitting up on the balcony with a friend of mine. He says, I hear that Rosemary's in the house. He says, come on down. And there's me with my high heels. And we'd nothing planned. And we just sang the song and we did a bit of harmonies and sang Let It Be Me. So he was great. But imagine trying to get down the balcony and down the stairs and get onto the stage, you know.
Well, do you know what? I've got one of Joe's biggest hits standing by, and we will play this one especially for you as well, as the title of the track is Good Looking Woman.
Oh, thank you so much, Robin.
Rosemary, it's been great to see you, as always.
You too.
And I'll see you in rehearsals.
Yes. Very soon. Scary, isn't it?
Aladdin at the Crescent Arts Centre. Do you know what they say? There's no show like a Joe show. See you soon, Rosemary.
All the best, Robin.